So here we are with another of my Sarah Key 2-minute talks, or thereabouts. Exercises for hip pain. Really, this is also exercises to prevent hip breakdown. Remember that the total hip replacement is perhaps the most successful orthopedic procedure. However, what this is really all about is preventing you ever getting to that point. And once again, as you see with so many of these little clips, it's really about the muscles and stopping the control of that hip joint going awry, which I'll now go on to explain. So first of all, a little bit about the anatomy of the hip joint. It's a very deeply set ball and socket joint, although it is a universal joint. It moves in all different directions, and that by and large bodes well for the future of the hip, because simply speaking, the more mobile a joint is, the less likely it is to break down. And hips, for that reason, are less likely to break down than the knee, for example. So here is the head of the femur. And see here, this beautiful fibroelastic cover, this shiny cartilage cover, preventing the bones rubbing together, preventing breakdown, preventing bone-to-bone rub. This is the all-important ingredient of any healthy joint, and of course synovial fluid flushing the joint, washing away bits of debris that do break off cartilage, which is a normal attrition of everyday life and events. Even so, the hip is a powerfully strong weight-bearing joint and does tend to break down. One of the reasons it breaks down is that the muscles, apart from being bearing massive forces of load all the time during normal ambulation, but also with running and jumping and any other sort of jarring activity. Very powerful muscles work the joint. You see here, gluteus medius, not shown here is gluteus maximus. These are our powerful locomotor muscles. They push us forward, they make us able to walk. But the adverse effect of such powerful muscles is that head of femur is all the time being rammed into that cup, into that socket, by the power of those muscles, in addition to the fact that there are such colossal downward load-bearing forces passing through the hip joint all the time. Now, the other important factor about the anatomy of the hip is that, totally unlike the shoulder, which is very mobile and not so stable, the hip is the converse, very stable, is that you have a less giving, less elastic hip capsule, and that binds the head of your femur into the socket. Now, what tends to happen is that with starting to limp, the muscles of the hip joint start to develop discord, with some muscles being over-switched on and some muscles not working hard enough. Which is why I say that it's really important not to limp. And as soon as we do start to limp, that's when those grinding forces of muscle overactivity adds to the attrition of weight-bearing. One of the first movements to disappear when the hip starts to break down is two, in fact. Two movements go first. The first movement to go is the backward angulation of the hip, called extension, so that when you're walking, and this is getting quite technical here, but because you have less angulation of the hip backwards, you have to take a shorter length of stride on the good leg. The other movement to disappear very quickly when the hip starts breaking down through muscle imbalance, too much tone of some muscles, not enough of others, is the outward movement called abduction. This is why this yoga posture is so fantastic for preventing hip breakdown, because you can see that it's opening the hip back as he pushes forward there, and it's also taking it out to the side. It's also twisting it open too. And you'll see these exercises are shown to you in the demonstrated exercises that I have now to follow. See how we go.